Hello, welcome back to BeatTech. This is Bee and you are going to watch our new series of episodes called SABY. In this series, I will let you know about current good smartphones in every budget department. So, let's check it out. So, let's start with devices ranging 5,000 to 10,000 rupees. According to me, in this range from 5 to 10,000 rupees, we have Xiaomi Redmi 2 Prime. This device cost 7,000 rupees and in every field it performs very good considering the price point. Other devices are also available which perform better than this device, but they lack on other departments. So, in overall, Redmi 2 Prime is like an all-rounder considering the price. We also have Lenovo A6000 Plus which performs very similar to Redmi 2 Prime. Both devices are very good in their class. If you don't want to buy Redmi 2 Prime or Lenovo A6000 Plus, then you can take a look at Meizu M2. This device also performs good and costs 7,000 rupees. The only con with this device is that the availability of service center in Meizu in India is not there. Only few service centers are available. And if your device damages or behaves annoyingly, then you have to go far to get rid of those problems. So, availability of services is very important according to me. And one another con is also present in M2, which is overheating. So, these two problems are there in M2. Otherwise, considering the price point, it is also a very good device. And if you can invest 2000 more in it, then you can also go for Foldpad Note 3, YP1, Asus Zenfone 2 Laser or Redmi Note 4G. On paper, Foldpad Note 3 goes far ahead of all the devices coming in this range. But practically, it's not the case. On paper, it has 3 gigs of RAM and performs good on Foldpad. And fingerprint sensor on this device is also very good. But other factors are deal breaker for this device, like average battery backup, cheap build quality, and camera is also very average. But if you are a person who wants more powerful device with 3 gigs of RAM and wants functionality of fingerprint sensor, then you can go for it. It costs 9,000 Indian rupees. And if you are a person who travels a lot, then with good battery backup, and for that you have Lenovo Y P1, which costs 8,000 Indian rupees and performs very good in the battery backup department. Lenovo Y P1 gives that battery backup which no other device gives. It gives about 8 to 9 hours of screen on time on medium to high usage. So, this device is good, let me clear myself, it's excellent in the battery backup. No any other smartphone, if you go over to 40 to 50,000, can give this battery backup. Only Lenovo Y P1M and his big brother Lenovo Y P1 gives this much of battery backup. But the camera on this is not good than Redmi 2 Prime and Lenovo A6000 Plus. So, if you want a camera smartphone, then Redmi 2 Prime and Lenovo A6000 Plus are very good devices in this price range. Apart from these devices, you can also go for Meizu M2 Note, which costs about 10,000 rupees and it performs good in all fields. Problem remains the same, which was less availability of service center and overheating. Instead of M2 Note, you can also consider Redmi Note 4G and Asus Zenfone 2 Laser. These both are very good devices. Redmi Note 4G costs about 10,000 Indian rupees and this device is best in its class. Note 4G has good performance and battery backup is also very good. But MIUI may be a hurdle for those who don't like MIUI. Otherwise, this device performs in every field considering the price point. Asus Zenfone 2 Laser also performs good, but the drawback of Asus Zenfones is that average camera quality. Otherwise, the device may go up from Redmi Note 4. So, these are the smartphones from 5 to 10,000 of range. See, every device is not a perfect smartphone. You have to choose your perfect device for you. If you are a person who travels a lot and wants a phone with huge battery and a very excellent battery backup, then you can go for YP1M. And If you are a person who clicks many photographs, then you want a device with a very good camera. You don't need a device having good gaming performance if you click many photographs. So device depends from person to person. You have to choose your perfect device, and I'm making this video to help you out how you can select your perfect device. So we have discussed about devices ranging from 5 to 10,000 rupees. Now let's talk about devices between 10 to 15,000 rupees. In this range, we don't have too many devices, but we have those who tries to compete with flagships. First is Xiaomi Mi4. Mi4 is a very good device. It performs excellent in every department, means good gaming, good multitasking, and it also has IR blaster. But the con of this device is that the lack of 4G connectivity, no expandable storage. If these are not the factors for you to be a hurdle, then you should definitely go for it. And if you want another choice, then we have Moto G 3 or Moto G 2015. This device is also very good. It feels good in hand, means handhold factor is great in this device. It costs 30,000 rupees and according to me, it's a very good device in this price range. If you want stock Android and hates MIUI, then you can go for Moto G instead of Mi 4. But Mi 4 performance is better than Moto G because of extra gigs of RAM. Moto G will get time to time latest Android updates. So if you are a stock Android lover, then this device is for you. So now let's move to devices which ranges 15 to 20,000 rupees. So in this range, we have 5 devices. Firstly, we have Lenovo White P1. So I am not ranking up the device. See, I am not ranking up the devices. You have to choose your device which suits best to you. So Lenovo White P1 costs 16,000 rupees, which is bigger brother of Lenovo White P1M. White P1 also has a huge battery which gives screen on time of 8 to 9 hours. And this screen on time is best among all the smartphones in the market. And I will repeat the line that if you are a person who can't charge your phone every day or travels a lot, then this device is for you. But the camera performance of this device is average and some frame drops are also there in heavy multitasking or gaming performance. Otherwise, it is a very good device. And now, in this range, we have Moto X Play, which cost 20,000 Indian rupees. Moto X Play is small brother of Moto X Style. Both the devices are very good, but Moto X Style goes in different price range. I will talk more about Moto X Style in later part of this video. So now come to Moto X Play. If you are a person who makes a lot of calls, then this is for you. The cellular call quality of Moto X Play is excellent. Moto X Play has good battery life, but in multitasking or in other some heavy stuff, it step back because of 2 gigs of RAM. I'm not saying that this device hangs a lot, but in some fields it hangs a little bit. But if you also get stock Android experience with this device. So if you are new to Android and want to taste and smell pure Android, then you can go for it. It will not disappoint you. And if you want more customization or Android, then you can check out OnePlus X and OnePlus One. OnePlus X costs about 17,000 rupees and OnePlus devices are only available on Amazon. So if you want to buy any device, then you can head over to description. There you can find the link of devices which comes under this video. And if you want to buy any of these devices, then use my link. It does help the channel and will show your support for our channel. So OnePlus One and OnePlus X are very good devices. OnePlus One cost 19,000 rupees. OnePlus One is also a device which killed every device when this device was launched. It has 3 gigs of RAM, 13 megapixel camera and lot more features. Performance is also very good. And if you don't want this sandstone back and want a designer piece of OnePlus, then OnePlus X is a perfect choice for you. These both the devices perform very good, but OnePlus One performs a little better than OnePlus X. The only con with OnePlus X is that it heats up a lot while gaming or multitasking. So, according to me, if you want a device of OnePlus in this price range, then invest 2000 more and go for OnePlus One. And if you want a good device than OnePlus X, then you can save your 2000 rupees and go for Xiaomi Mi4. These both devices are very good. I will prefer Mi4 and OnePlus One over OnePlus X. So, the choice is yours. So, I have suggested best performing devices in price range of 15 to 20,000 rupees. Now, let's switch over to those devices which comes in price range of 20 to 30,000 rupees. In this range, we have very good devices which perform very good in every field, whether it is a camera performance, battery performance, or overall performance. So, firstly, we have OnePlus 2, which costs 25,000 rupees and is available on Amazon. OnePlus 2 is a very good device and it has sandstone back with metal bezels on side. This device is a very good device considering the price point. In 25,000 rupees, you get an excellent device. It has a very good camera, 4 gigs of RAM, which forces the performance of this device. So, this device is very good in my opinion, and if you want a device in 25,000 rupees, then this is the perfect choice. And if you can invest 30,000 rupees in your device, then you can go for Moto X Style. Moto X Style gives a pure stroke Android experience. So if you are an Android lover, and again, I will say that want to smell the pure Android, then this is for you. Moto X Style also has voice command, which performs as a skin over the Google Now. So you can control your Moto X with your voice. So this is the additional feature you get with the Moto X Style. Moto X Style has a very good camera, very good performance, and in all these things it performs great. So these were the devices between 20 to 30,000 rupees. Now let's switch over to devices ranging 30,000 rupees plus. So in this range we have many devices. Actually, we have flagships. In this range, we have devices which perform very good and all have a very special feature with them. All the devices are having their unique features, like S6 Edge has edge screen, iPhone 6s has 3D touch, Xperia Z5 has waterproof technology, and LG G4 has Nexus XP is an all-rounder with having fastest fingerprint sensor and a very, actually, the best of all the devices camera. So, Samsung Note 5, which has S Pen, and LG G4. Hey man, LG G4 has nothing. So, from all these devices, the best device is Nexus 6P, which performs great, excellent in every field. The design of Nexus 6P is very good. Actually, this is my favorite design from all the smartphones of 2015. It performs very good in all fields. It has a very good camera which performs very good also in low light conditions. It costs about 40,000 rupees. So you can go for Nexus 6P from all the devices according to me. And if you don't want Nexus, then you can consider Samsung Note 5. Note 5 is a very good device with a very good camera and it will give you the functionality of S Pen. So if you want S Pen, then you can consider the Note 5. And if you are an Apple lover, then you can go for iPhone 6s. 6s is also a very good device. And from LG, we have LG G4, which is also a very great device. Performance is good, but the only con with the LG G4 is that it has a very bad battery backup. If you want to use LG G4 and charge in the early morning, then you have to charge it in the afternoon. So the battery backup is very bad. You can also consider Xperia Z5, which is also a very good device. But if you don't want, these phones are all the branded phones. And according to me, the best device from these is the Nexus 6P. You can go for it. And if you want to buy any of these devices, you can head over to description. The links are available in the description. So, thanks for watching. I hope you like my video. If you then click the like button and please make sure you are subscribed to my channel to get the latest updates of these devices and other stuff, techy stuff. So this is B signing off. You guys have a great day. Bye bye. Have a nice day.